Good morning, student. In the last lecture, we have started with the type study, that is the phylum Echinodermata. Under phylum Echinodermata, we have started with the starfish, that is the Estrias rubens. Okay, so we have already completed the systematic position of a starfish plus a brief introduction. Okay, so in today's lecture, we are going to start with one of the important characteristic features that make that character is only found in the echinoderms. Okay, else it this the presence of pedicellaria. Okay, that is one type of modified spine which is only found in the echinoderms. Else it is not found in other members of kingdom Animalia. Okay, so pedicellaria are microscopic pincer like structure which will be embedded in a skin of echinoderms, and they are the modified form of the spines. Okay, they are found at the base of the spine, both on the oral as well as aboral surfaces. Okay, and pedicellaria are peculiar to the echinoderms. Hence, they are not formed in any other animal groups. Okay. So, first we are going to see what are the structural or typical structure of the pedicellaria. Okay. A pedicellaria consists of stalk and three ossicles, and these ossicles are calcareous plate. Okay. The stalk is flexible. And at the one end of the stalk, it will be embedded or attached to the skin. Okay, in the skin. And there will be a free end of the stalk. One end is attached to the or embedded in the skin, while the other end is a free. Okay, whereas it bears a three ossicles. And of these three ossicles, one lie at horizontal at the apex of the stalk. Okay, and this one ossicle is termed as basal piece. Okay, it is immovable, whereas the other two ossicles are movable, which will be articulated with the stalk in a vertical position. Okay, and this vertical ossicles are called as a jaws or valves. Okay, whereas they will be having the inner jaw or inner margin of the jaw are serrated. Okay, and this jaw can be open and closed by two sets of muscles. Okay, basically like you have heard about the adductor muscles. Okay, so mollusk will be echinoderms. In mollusk, you have heard about the adductor muscles. Similarly, in echinoderm also, there are adductor muscles. Okay, so there will be pair of adductor muscles which bring about this closure and the opening of the jaws. Okay, and these muscles basically lie between the basal piece and the jaws. Okay, the closure of the jaw is brought about by the operation of two pairs of adductor muscles. Okay, the closing system, the closing of the jaw will be carried out by the two pairs of adductor muscles. Okay, similarly, the opening of the jaw is brought about by the operation of only one pair of the adductor muscles. So only like adductor muscle will play role in both the closing plus opening of the jaws. Only the number of pairs of adductor muscles will be differed. So closure of the jaws will bring about by the operation of two pairs of jaws, whereas the opening of the jaw will be brought about by the operation of a pair of adductor muscles. Okay, and the jaw work like a forceps in this type of arrangement of the jaws will is work like a forceps, and this type of pedicellaria is termed as forcipulate pedicellaria. Okay, the arrangement of a jaws and functioning of a jaws, this type of jaws will be termed as a forcipulate pedicellaria. Okay, so now we will see what are the different types of pedicellaria. There are basically two types of pedicellaria, and they are pedunculate pedicellaria and other is sessile pedicellaria. Okay, pedunculate pedicellaria is further classified into two types based on the structure or the appearance of the jaws. Okay, the first is the straight pedicellaria and other is the crossed pedicellaria. Okay, first we'll see what is the pedunculate pedicellaria is. The pedunculate pedicellaria is also known as stalk pedicellaria because they have a stalk. Okay, and they are basically found in estrus, that is in starfish, and all the pedicellaria are pedunculate type. In estrus, the order the class estrus will be having, the estroidae will be having pedunculate pedicellaria. Okay, this pedunculate pedicellaria has a stalk and three ossicles. Okay, namely the basal piece, this ossicles will be having a basal piece and two jaws. Okay, the pedunculate pedicellaria is further classified into two types, namely the straight pedicellaria or straight type, and second is the cross pedicellaria or cross type. The straight pedicellaria, for the brief understanding, we'll refer a diagrammatic picture of straight pedicellaria and the cross pedicellaria. The straight pedicellaria or the straight type pedicellaria will be having a two jaws which will be remain straight on a basal piece. Okay, and this basal and jaws will work like a forceps, and the straight pedicellaria is found in a starfish. Okay, and that is also known as a forcipulate pedicellaria. Okay, the next type is the crossed pedicellaria. In a crossed pedicellaria, the basal part of the jaw are curved and they are crossed on each other. Okay, so they will work like a scissor. Okay, thus the jaws are crossed on each other. The type of pedicellaria termed as a crossed pedicellaria. Okay, then next type of pedicellaria is the sessile pedicellaria. This sessile pedicellaria will be having no stalk, or it is without stalk. Okay, and it is situated in a small depression on the skin called as alveoli. Okay, and this alveoli are the depression on the skin. Okay, and they are like and in this type so this is the picture of bivalve alveolar pedicellaria. Okay, and it has a two jaws. As I already said, this sessile pedicellaria will be having or without a stalk. Okay, so it is embedded in a small depression on the skin called as a alveolus, and it has two jaws which will be arranged like a of a clamp. and they can be open and closed by the operation of muscles. The similar, the adductor muscles will bring about the opening and the closure of the jaws. Okay, and sessile pedicelliria are not found in the estrus, but they are found in other members of Estroridae, that is Oreaster, like Oreocetes, which is allied to the estrus group. Okay, this is about the type of pedicelliria. We have seen the structure and the type of pedicelliria and what is pedicelliria is. Now we will going to see about functions of the pedicelliria. The pedicelliria function as a organ in offense and defense. Okay, and has the jaws. It will be sharp and will be having a teeth like structure. So it is help in protecting, like against the predator. Okay, then it is also used in cleaning the surface of the body. Both arboreal and oral surface of the body can be cleaned by using pedicelliria. That is, they will remove debris, then sand grains. Okay, then they are also used this pedicelliria to capture a small prey. Okay, and they also protect the papulae. So papulae are the organ of respiration. Okay, that is basically in sea star they will breathe passively. So they will be having a finger like sac called as a papulae, which will bring about oxygen rich sea water that will flow through the papulae. Okay, and it also protected by a plates. And the function of this papulae is similar to that of the gills, that is absorption of the oxygen or exchange of oxygen from the water with surface of the papulae. Okay, with this we have completed the pedicelliria. If you have any questions regarding this subtopics, then please let me know. Thank you.